Hello and welcome back to another video. Today we're making this cracked 3D text effect in Photoshop. So I used this text effect in my recent header, which you can find a speed art of it in the right corner. So go take a look. So it's really simple and a cool way to do text in Photoshop. But before we start, I would like to thank whatfontis.com for sponsoring this video. Their service lets you identify almost any font on the internet, giving you exact results and related fonts that you can download. Find out more about whatfontis.com later in the video. Okay, so in Photoshop, I'm going to just make a new document, but you're going to make this like in your banner or whatever you're using this for. And I'm going to start off by grabbing my text tool, and I'm using the font Burbank Big Condensed, the Fortnite font. I will have it in the description, of course. I'm just going to type out text, any color. Ctrl T, I'm going to make it a little bit bigger. Perfect. I'm going to then right click on the text layer and rasterize it. Then Ctrl and T, I'm going to right click and we're going to put a perspective on it. So then just press down Shift and grab this like top right anchor point and just like drag it inwards. And get this like tilted, you know. We can also grab the last point right here on the corner and drag it out to get more of the effect. Now we're going to add a gradient, so just double click on the layer, bring up the layer styles. We're going to add a gradient overlay. I'm going to make mine like red, orange, yellow type of gradient. Looks like this. Going to have it like this. Perfect. I will have the hex codes in the description if you want to use the same colors. Press down Ctrl and J to make a duplicate. And we're going to rasterize the layer style on this one. Drag it below. We're going to add a color overlay, which is like this, like kind of dark brown. It should be like a darker color of the, like the main color you're using. Then press down Ctrl and T. I'm going to press down Shift to make it a bit smaller. Put it in the middle and then put it just a little bit below. And we get this really easy like 3D effect. But of course we have some like gaps, you know, here and there. So we're just going to fill them in. And because on this like 3D back layer, because it has a color overlay, we can just fill it in with any color. So I'm just going to grab the polygonal letter tool, zoom in on one point, one letter. I'm going to make a point between these and make a selection, Ctrl and backspace to fill it in, and it will automatically be the same color that we're using. Here you might just want to like just eyeball it. I think it will go somewhere around here. Connect it, make a selection, and then Ctrl and backspace to fill it in. I'm just going to make this with every layer. Okay, here we have just like a really simple 3D effect. On the like the main text layer, I'm going to add another layer style, which is like a bevel and a boss. So I'm just using the style in the bevel technique, just hard depth at max. Size you can play around with. So yeah, and you can use like any color you want as the highlight. I'm using like yellow because like, yeah, it's brighter than orange. Yeah, perfect. So I just want to add like some sort of texture to the text so it looks like a more, it's looking a little more rough. So I'm going to go open my pack, the regular pack, and we're going to go to like the grunge folder. And I just want to add like some sort of like texture, like, yes, I think this one will do. So you just drag it over to our document, make it a clip mask, and you might want to just right click and rasterize the layer style so we can actually can see the texture. I'm just going to make it a little bit smaller so we don't lose any quality, just like that. And set a nice blending mode, like color dodge, and you can bring down the opacity or leave it at max. It's up to you. But yeah, now we have some like sort of texture. I'm just going to duplicate this texture layer and make the clip mask to the 3D part as well. But of course, then you need to rasterize the layer style so we actually can see it. We're making this layer instead of color dodge. I think like soft light or something like that. Perfect. But before we continue, let's find out how what font is actually works. Let's say you're scrolling through Twitter or Behance and you see a font that you really like, but you don't know the name of it. So just grab a screenshot of the text and head over to whatfontis.com and upload your screenshot. After a few quick steps, you can see a list of very similar fonts, and in 99% of the case, the exact font you want. I really like this service because unlike other systems, it also identifies free fonts and not only commercial ones. You can find fonts from Google Fonts or the font. A lot of fonts, yeah. So the next time you need to identify a font, just go straight to whatfontis.com and get the exact one you're looking for. You can find the link in the description. Thank you. So now it's time for like adding like the cracked effect. So I'm just going to add this like cracked, I don't really call it, some, it's like a PNG of some cracked things. I'm going to make it a clip mask to our main text layer. Just like that. I'm going to make it the blending mode linear burn. Perfect. Now you just want to like position the layer where you want to apply like the cracked effect, because if you position it about right here, we can see that we can use this like this black empty space and just delete it off the text. So yeah, that's exactly what we're going to do. So grab our like magic wand tool and press on this like the darker area. You can just press down shift, you want to select multiple areas and connect them. Maybe down here as well. Kind of like that. And when you have selected everything that you want gone, go back to our main text layer, have that selected, and then just press delete. And if you just shade the transparency, as you can see, we have like a broken 3D like cracked effect. Yeah, that is really cool. And then we can just like duplicate this cracked layer, and we can put it maybe on the next letter, or if you want to skip it, you can put it on the X or whatever. I think I want to put it like right here on the E. So again, you select the dark areas that you want gone, and when you're happy with the selection, go back to our like the main text layer and just press delete. Backspace works as well. And yeah, you get this. If you, because like the layer is quite like, you know, big and such, you can use the eraser tool to like remove the cracks on, if you don't want the cracked effect on other on the other layers. Yeah, it's duplicated. Make sure it's a clip mask, of course. Get to put it maybe up here. That is cool. So yeah, when you have a bit of position, just like go ahead, select the thing you want. And when you're ready, go back to the main layer, delete it, and but as you can see here, it looks kind of weird, so we want to delete it off the 3D layer as well. So just do that. You see, it's a little bit better. You might want to go in there with the eraser tool and adjust it a little bit. But yeah, that's like the main thing. You might just want to go ahead and, you know, remove some of the cracks where it's like it's too much. And yeah, that's it basically. So yeah, I really hope you enjoy it. And please give this video a like, and don't forget to check out whatfontis.com. Yeah, thank you, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.